As you can see, we mainly broke convention thus far by deciding to present our OTS in the style of a split screen. We decided to do this because it helps develop our complex storyline quicker and creatively in the short time space given to us by the exam board. We were able to tell the story of Sam's demise as well as the killer's preparations simultaneously.
It also enabled us to confirm a film production convention of including many very credit. We felt this important because last year's examiner's report slated this centre for a lack of titles and horror opening sequences. Despite most horror opening sequences having very few titles, we didn't want to find ourselves discriminated against due to the grief.
We chose the soundtrack of Massive Attack because the title is ironic, as it is about a prostitute and the music provides the perfect case for our split screen presentation. Our target audience will probably be familiar with the track and therefore appreciate the irony. In this way, we are developing the genre by including our own characters to a postmodern.
There is a recurring theme of lights throughout our opening title sequence. It is often common in horror to have an icon recurring throughout. In this way, we follow conventions. For example, the pumpkin in Halloween and the ring-shaped objects in The Ring, and more recently, the use of CCTV in Paranormal Activity in Scream 4 and the dolls in Women in Black.
We put our title originally across two of the split screens, and then they move so that the passenger is in black. This is the link to the title of Passenger. We also ensured that there was a blue screen next to the title, as blue is often associated with horror. Passenger is a really clever title for our film, because like many other successful contemporary horrors, are only one word, such as Mama, Insidious and Sinister. We were also inspired by Dexter, who often talks about his dark passenger, which makes him kill people.
We included classic icons of horror to offer some form of conventional pattern, so that people would recognise the genre of horror. For example, this shot shows the bloodied rope being twisted by mannequins in a dirty jumper. This juxtaposes beautifully with the tacky sleeping bag with the whore. Again, there is a beautiful use of irony of the killer's preparation, checking his tape whilst our prostitute's preparation.
He
is putting on her makeup. It was a split screen that enabled us to do this.
The imagery of the room and the voyage of the car is tangled because it depicts the journey of preparation after death in this way, the death that is developed in Russia by adding more metaphorical narrative tracks instead of going all out gore to intrigue the audience. The use of low-key street lighting also helps develop an atmosphere that the audience would associate with horror.
The sexual imagery of our opening title sequence helped to pull in a male audience. For example, the provocative lacing of boots, the erection of the lipstick, and the potential use of rope and tape as bondage items. Coupled with the sexy music, this offers our opening title sequence a draw for male audience to keep watching.
Our main character is a classical woman victim. This is because of the blonde hair and also the way that she is dressed. Black short skirt, tights, red lipstick. The tarty look pulls in the male audience. The red represents the seduction that Sam portrays.
The killing sequence.
Keep going, don't stop it.
The killing sequence with our film is a typical horror iconic scene because it involves a strong, typical male killer murdering a vulnerable girl in his car. The killer involves pushing his hand over the girl's mouth, which shows the strength of the murderer.
Matches up with the climax of the soundtrack. This enables the audience to realise the situation as an important part of the opening sequence, as her kidnap and hinted murder are not just random acts of violence, but a planned murder is part of the
opening. The opening title sequence is quite intimately legal to the rest of the movie. The ending of the car driving away is listening to the audience to wonder if the attacker actually killed the girl.